At the end of this tutorial, you will learn how to build your very own spam email classifier using large language models. The fun part of this is that every resource we are going to use will be free. The API key you need will be free, which you don't have to pay a penny to use it. Okay, this is going to be a fun project, and I also don't hesitate to teach you how to set up everything you need. Oh wait, so before we get started, if you have not yet subscribed, make sure you hit the subscribe button and also share this tutorial to friends that you think might benefit from this. Because according to YouTube, over 83% of my viewers have not yet subscribed. And guys, this doesn't encourage me to produce much tutorials at all. So do subscribe and I'll keep the content coming. Enough with my self-promotion stuff, so let's get right into it. So to start off, let's go through the files we will need, and we'll first look at the requirements. So over here, we need Crew AI. We'll also install Grok, and then we'll install LangChain Grok. Okay, so these are the three libraries we are going to use in this particular tutorial. When you just do pip install requirement.txt, this is going to install everything for you. And at the end of the tutorial, I'm going to make sure everything will be on my GitHub repository. The link will be in the description where you guys can leverage this and use it in your own code. Why not? Okay, then the second thing is to get your free API key. Guys, this is free, so you can use it for free. And the fun part of it is that it's very fast. Okay, it's faster than the GPT API keys, and this gives you your result instantly. So let me first teach you how you can set up this API key for free. So for that, I'll open my browser, and the first thing you do is to head over to Grok AI. In my previous tutorial, I showed you how to set up Grok AI, how to create an account and get free API keys for different models. Guys, just check this out. So when you come to model here, we have free models here that you can use. So model from Google Gemini, 7 billion parameters. Then these are from Meta AI. We have the 70 billion parameter model and 8 billion parameter model, Llama 3. And also we have a model from Mistral. So you can use any of these models in your project, and it's free, guys. So just head over to Grok AI and then create an account, and then you get access. So after getting access, the first thing I want you to do is to click on API keys and click on create API key. And with this, you can just create an API key for free. So you write the name for API key. And then, so for instance, let's say I want API key. So I'll call it spam email. And all I need to do is to submit this. So after submitting, this will generate a new API key for me, and I can copy, click on done, and just come here to replace it so that we can use it. So I'll clear this old API key, guys. So after this tutorial, I'm going to revoke this API key because it's very easy for everyone to create his or hers. So just go ahead and create your own API key. So that's it, and you have to make sure this is in .env file. Okay, so I can get rid of that. And the next thing I'll go and do is to create a new file, which I'll call spam.ipynb. So this is IPython notebook that we are going to create. All right, so it seems our notebook is ready. And first of all, we have to import some libraries, okay? So from .env, I'll import load.env, okay? And also from LangChain, we are going to import some couple of libraries, which I'll explain them whilst we are using them in the code. Okay, so from LangChain, we import the prompt template. We also import the string output parser to get our output as a string. You see all these things in code. And then we also import Grok. Okay, so these are the dependencies we import. So we select this particular virtual environment I've created called VMV. And this will connect to our kernel before running our code. Before I forget, make sure you put .env here so that it will install .env. I think automatically it will install, but you can just put python-env so that it will install it as well for you. Okay, so this went ahead and connected to our kernel, and also it has run the code successfully. So our imports are ready. And the next thing we'll go ahead and do now is to load in our API key so that we can set up the model and use this model in our code. So I'll do load.env, and this will go ahead and load all environmental variables. So that will be our API keys. And right after that, I'll get the API key. So I'll call this API key. And here's where the OS library shines. So os.getenv. And in here, you put the name of the API key, guys. So the name right here is what? Olama key. So you have to make sure you put that same name here for it to work. So I'll put the same name here. And this will read that particular API key for me. In case you want to check whether the key is read, you can just write API key. And this will print it for you. So you can see we have the API key being read. Okay. So I'll make sure I remove it so that it doesn't show the API key once again. All right. So now time to set up our model. So we'll set up the model. We'll call this model, and this will be equal to chat grok. And inside here, we'll give it a couple of things. Our API key, which is equal to API key. Also, you have to give it the model you want to use. So we'll give it model name. That should be underscore name. And this will be equal to the particular model you want to use. So guys, now it's up to you to select any model at all you want to use. So when you come to Playground, you can select any of these models. Okay. So we'll start off using maybe this particular model, Llama, the 70 billion parameter, which is very big. So for that, I can come here and copy the name of that particular model. And I'll go back in my code and paste it right here. All right, so that's how simple you can set up the model. And we will run this code and see if it works. That's fine. Now we can go ahead and even test this model, okay? So we can do our model.invoke. And we ask any question at all. I'm thinking this is live, then I can take questions from you. But since it's not live, I can give the question myself. So as usual, I'll ask what is coding. I think this is fun. And let's see. So you can see the model is working, and you can see how fast it has returned the output. So guys, the output here is AI message, and what we need is the content. So that's why I've imported a string output parser. So for that, we have to create a parser so that we will always get only the content. So I'll call this parser, and this is equal to string output parser. Okay. Then over here, in order to get the output, I have to chain the parser together with the model in order to get whatever I want. And that's the chaining effect of LangChain. So I'll chain my model together with my parser, and I'll call this chain. So my chain is equal to my model together with my parser. I can get rid of this. And instead of model.invoke, now we can just go ahead and do chain.invoke. And this will go ahead and get us only the content, not the AI message. And you can see coding, also known as computer programming, blah blah blah. We don't need it. Okay. So this is how we can set up the model and get our content from the model. So now back to our project. Now what we want to do is to what, classify spam emails and non-spam emails. And with this, I'm going to use email from my personal inbox so that we can see how best this model will attempt to solve this problem. Okay. All right, so what we will have to do here is to come up with a template, okay? And this template is going to instruct our language model on what to do, okay? So I can just, I've designed this template, which is very simple. I'll paste it here. So it's template, and here, what I'm telling this model is that as an expert spam email classifier, you are equipped to analyze and categorize any given email as either spam or non-spam. Upon evaluation, you will generate a comprehensive report detailing the classification outcome. Okay, so the model is not going to only classify spam or non-spam. At the end of the day, it's going to generate a very good report for us to know what is happening in there. Okay, so that's what the template is doing. And at the end, what we give to this template will be the mail. So we give it the mail, and it will go ahead and perform the magic for us. So after the template, now we can use our prompt template that we've imported here to format this template, and it will go ahead to take the input and do the job. So we'll call it prompt, and this is equal to prompt template dot from templates. All right, so inside here, just give it your template. So template is equal to the name we have given. There is also called template. So that's it. Okay. Then at the down here, we can format this template. Guys, this should be prompt. I have written prompt. We can do prompt the format. Okay. And in here, we can say, okay, this is the email. Do this for us. Okay. So give it the mail, and the mail is equal to, okay, here is the mail. So we are telling here is the email, then we add the email to it, then it is going to go ahead and work things out for us. Okay. We can even print this, or I think after running it will, yeah. So you can see the prompt now is as an expert spam classifier, you are dot dot dot. I think printing this will be pretty good. Okay, so I'll wrap this in a print statement for you guys to see how it looks. Okay, so this is how it go. As an expert, blah blah blah. So this is the prompt, then here is the email, then this will be followed by the given email you've provided it. So this is the instruction that large language model is going to use to classify your mails. Before take even reading the mail, it knows what to do. So it's like you are giving it a context, then it takes the mail and do the job for you based on this provided context. So by tweaking this context, which is also termed maybe prompt engineering, you get better results from large language models. Okay. All right. So now we have our prompt template. What's next? The next thing is to chain this prompt template together with our model and our parser in order to get results. So for that, we'll say our final chain is equal to the prompt template, which will be sent to the model, and the model output will also pass through the parser in order to give us only the content. I'll run this, and we have no errors. And the final thing we can do here is to test this model out. So to test this out, we have to get some email. So I told you guys earlier that I'm going to use email from my own inbox, which is a spam mail. So Google has classified that as a spam email, and I'm going to use the model to also do the same to see whether it can classify the same email. Alright, so I'll head over to my inbox, and you can see I'm in my spam mail, and this some nice spam mail sent to me. So I'll go ahead and choose this one and just copy it. Okay, I'll copy it right here, and over here I'll just paste it. It's very long, so I think I can break this down for it to look a little bit nicer. Okay, so these guys are Mr. Worthworth, and I work at the Prime Bank in Turkey, blah blah blah. I don't know. He's trying to he's trying to scam me one way or the other. So we'll be using this mail. Syntax error. What's the problem? Okay, so I think what I need to do here is to shift this to the top. Okay, so now I have the mail, I have my chain set up, I have my model set up. What I can go ahead and do now is to say, okay, my result is equal to my chain dot invoke, and in here we can give it a mail. So I can say mail, and this will go ahead and classify this mail and also write a given report on it for me. So let's see, let me give it a run, and the moment of truth is doing the job, and now we can go ahead and visualize the result. Let's see. Okay, so I don't like how it's showing up. What I can do is to print it. And just by printing it, sometimes it looks nicer in your IPython notebook. So I'll go ahead and run this. And this is the job it has done. So you can see spam classification report, email subject not provided, email body as provided, classification. So you can see it has classified it as a spam email. And reasoning, urgency, and scarcity tactic. So the email creates a sense of urgency by proposing a proposal, blah, blah, blah. So you can see, guys, it is able to classify this email as a spam, and I just like how it's doing the job. Okay, I just like how everything turns out. So we can test it out with another mail to see how it will also classify it. Also, I can just shift this code down to make it look nicer. right after our chain, we are having our result and everything. Okay, so what I'll do is to work on the next email. Before I go through the next email, you can see it has given you recommendation. Delete this email and do not respond to it. It is a scam, and any further communication may lead to financial loss or identity theft. So it has given you what to do. It has suggested what to do for you, and I think this is very good enough. Okay, so before we move on to the next mail, we can even try different model to see how it will work this same thing out. So I'll head over to my Grok AI platform, and this time around I'm going to use Mistra. So let me try it out. This is my first time trying Mistra out, guys. So this particular model, I'll grab it and go back to my code, and I'll paste it right here. So this is Mistra, baby. Let's see how it works. Run the model through the whole process once again, and let's see the result. Very clean. So you can see for Mistra, it gives you classification spam, then it gives you the reasoning, and then it gives you it lists out some points for you. So you can see these factors collectively suggest that the mail is a spam message. So it has list this points for you and tells you that okay, it's a spam message. So you can see, I think I love how Mistra is able to organize this out than Llama, even though the Llama model is bigger than it. So guys, let's test the final mail, and then we can end this tutorial. So for that, I'll go back to my spam mail, and let's try this one out. Okay, so this guy said he's Patel, and I'll copy his mail, go back and paste it right here. Okay, so I'm not going to format this one. I'll just run through it and view my results. So it says this one is non-spam. I don't know, but I said non-spam. The person in question is from a person who introduced themselves as a research. So it classified it as not spam, but Google said this mail is a spam. Okay. And upon reading it myself, I think I don't know any person like this, and per what the person is saying, based in the United Kingdom, I'm currently seeking a trustworthy business professional individual in your region and whatsoever. I think it's a spam mail, but it is saying it's not a spam, and let's test it out with another model to find out what it will also say about the same thing. So I'm going back to Llama, and I'll use this particular Llama model for it, and let's see. Llama on the show, I'll run it, come back here, run this again, and let me see what Mr. Llama will also say about this mail. So for Llama, okay, reasoning for classification. So Llama says this is a spam, okay. Confidence level, it has 95% confidence that it is a spam mail. Llama on the show, Llama 3 in action. So guys, let me know your thoughts about this project. Let me know if you enjoy it. Also, let me know what you think about this particular email, the control VC, and blah blah blah. So guys, this is it. This is all for this tutorial. You've learned how to set up and use open source large language models for free, and also enjoy the speed that comes with Grok AI. So thanks for watching, and as usual, I'm going to see you in the next video.